Fáilte go God Save the Quine, program a chéad in luach ar borinich alapanach an a sil hiúil hain an bliomachin. Tron a program bish na clountain mu vehin iantach na runa gan a hasho. Fa loch cúil úra a halarach an slia sig niavachas, gu fagin a gag larich ar an cúlu. Ach dé díroch a hórsi na va sogaif.
My career in music kind of started by accident, really. I was singing along one night at a party and one of them said to me, you know, you should come along and audition for a band as a backing singer. So I did and ended up singing backing vocals in various bands.
Achta ní an eile a bheith fyrach gan a flatwecker tú siar golasgu fa a harach ag mór roibbe nir a huar curach fa Deacon Blue.
I didn't have a phone. Very few people did, really, students and stuff in those days. And I got a letter through the letterbox from their tour manager saying, we've been trying to contact you. The band want you to come down to London and sing on the album. It was a fantastic night. I was so excited. I thought, yeah, this is probably what I'm going to do. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but something good's going to happen because of this. I really believed that, and it did. I had been studying to be a teacher at college in Glasgow, and I hadn't really told my dad that I had now given up being a teacher and I was now in a band. So when he found out that this had happened, he was absolutely furious, you know, and he's saying to me, you've been in bands before and they'll all fall away and it'll be nothing and you have to be a teacher, you have to have something to fall back on. So it wasn't until we appeared on the Terry Wogan show, which was a massive deal in those days, that my dad suddenly thought, it's okay.
We'll close with a piece of music, different kind of music, with a band of young Scots around the verge of pop music stardom. They're already climbing the Sassenach charts at a rate of McNutt's, with a song called Dignity. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, Deacon Blue.
There's a man I meet, walks up our street. He's a worker for the council, has been 20 years. And he takes no lip off nobody, and litter off the gutter. Puts it in a bag, and never thinks to mutter.
Deacon Blue, good job of a sort of a chulka come.
You have to constantly fight for your corner, I think, in every aspect of being in the music industry. I am a really opinionated human being, and I always have been. And women who are opinionated are not seen as opinionated. They're seen as overbearing or, you know, screeching or, you know, henpecking people. And it's taken me a long time not to be scared of those titles. We had a nanny came with us, but I wasn't very good at handing over the baby to the nanny, so I'd want to do everything and I was completely knackered. And you'd be on a tour bus and you'd be aware you had a baby and the rest of the guys who had been used to smoking up the back and playing poker, and suddenly we're saying, and this is the days when smoking was still acceptable everywhere, and we're saying, so from now on, guys, there's going to be no smoking on the bus. And they were really, really good about it. They wanted to stop every 10 minutes for a cigarette. I remember this guy saying to me, he was a stylist, he brought all his clothes, looked through them all, and I said, no, I don't want to wear them, sorry. And he actually said to me, you know, you're getting the reputation of being a bit of a bitch to work for.
I always find it quite funny because a lot of the time the stylists can be the worst dressed people in the room.
I said, what? He said, yeah, you know, that's, and in the stylist world, you know, people bring you, it's the latest this and the latest, and you're not interested. And I thought, and that makes me a bitch, you know, just because you want to look the way you want to look.